Welcome back to my class. Today we will discuss a new method for the calculation of national income, and that is income method. So in this class we learned that how national income is measured using the income method. Income method measures the national income from the side of the payments which are made to the primary factors of production in the form of rent, wages, interest and profit for their productive services in during an accounting year. So let us see the factors of production. We are knowing factors of productions are hired by the producing sector. So whenever the factors of productions are being hired, the producing sector, the producers, they used to make the payments, and that payments are estimated, that payments are counted, and that payments give us the value of domestic income. So let us see firstly this factors of production. Factors of production are of two types. One is known as this primary factor, second one is known as secondary factors. So we are not concerned with the secondary factor. Secondary factor, because we are knowing the raw materials, energy, transportation, these are the secondary factors. So while the national income is calculated, the secondary factors, the payment for the secondary factors are not taken consideration. Only the payments made for the use of primary factors of production are taken consideration into the calculation of the national income. So according to this method, income method, let us see what is national income or how is the national income calculated. So this national income is equal to domestic income. This is domestic income plus net factor income earned from abroad. So domestic income, you are knowing, domestic income, the income generated within the domestic territory of a country during an accounting year. And this is also known as net domestic product. Net domestic product at factor cost. Factor cost, why do we call? Because the income received by the factors of production. So NDPFC, and this you are knowing, the net factor income earned from abroad means the net factor income received from the rest of the world. And this we can write in short, net factor income from abroad. And this is national income. National income, we have seen national income. So this national income, in technically we call it NNP factor cost. We call it NNP factor cost. So this national income having two component, one is net domestic product factor cost, another one is net factor income from abroad. Let us see this net domestic product factor cost. This is also known as this domestic income. And domestic income or NDPFC is classified into three categories. There are three categories of this. One is called, first one is compensation of employees. Compensation of employees. Compensation of employees, and second one is known as operating surplus. Third one is known as mixed income of self-employed. So there are three categories of the domestic income. Domestic income is being classified, broadly classified, into three categories. First category is known as compensation of employees. Second one is known as operating surplus. Third one is known as mixed income of self-employed. This is called compensation of employees, we call. And this we call, let us see, operating surplus. This we call mixed income in short. I think it's clear. COE means compensation of employees, OS means operating surplus, and mixed income. And this first step, compensation of employees, compensation means the payments which are made to the workers, to the employees, from the employers. So this consists of wages and salaries. You are knowing, let us see, wages and salaries are made to the workers. Wages and salaries consist of the monetary payments as well as non-monetary payments and other benefits. Monetary payments means the payments made to the workers in the form of cash, in the form such as cash payment includes the basic salaries, includes the dearness allowances, it includes the commissions, etc. So wages and salaries paid to the employees in cash consist of, I told you, this basic salary, dearness allowances, commission, and the wages and salaries paid to the workers in non-monetary fund. Non-monetary fund consists of rent-free housing or rent-free housing, free car facilities, then free education to their children, then free education to the children. So all sort of free education, this type of facilities, we can say wages and salaries, or free medical facilities, free medical facilities, free education facilities. These all comes under the wages and salaries. Number B is the employer's contribution. Employer's contribution to social security scheme. So employers are contributing. The employers are making contribution into the different schemes which are related to the employees, such as, let us see, provident fund schemes are there, or general provident fund schemes are there, then labor fund schemes are there, gratuity fund schemes are there. So different schemes which are related to the workers, in that schemes the employers are making contribution. That contribution is also being calculated, that is estimated by the Central Statistical Organization in order to know the value of the national income. So compensation of employees having two components: one is wages and salaries, second one is employer's contribution to social security scheme. And the second components of the domestic income or the NDPFC is operating surplus. Operating surplus, this consists of number A, this consists of rent and royalties. Rent, you are knowing, the payments made to the owner of land and building. Royalties are also made for the use of certain trademarks and sometimes copyright, sometimes franchises, sometimes the use of mineral deposits. So all sort of payments are known as royalties. So rent and royalties are estimated, and they are also included into the net domestic factor income. The second one is the interest. Interest, you are knowing, interest is the payment for the use of capital. So all sort of interest, whether the interest are actual interest or imputed interest, these all are calculated, estimated, and included into the operating surplus or NDPFC. And C is the, let us see, the profits. Profit is the reward paid to the enterprises. So reward paid to the enterprises are known as profits. And profits, let us see, is also classified into three categories. Some part of the profits are paid to the shareholders, and some part of the profits are paid to the government, and some part of the profits are retained for further expansion or for contingency uses. So profits is further classified. Profits are classified into, first one is dividends. Dividends. And dividends, let us see, dividends. Dividends means the payments made to the shareholders. Second one is corporate tax. Corporate tax. Corporate tax is the tax on, paid to the government on profit. And corporate tax is the direct tax, we can say, because it is directly collected from the entrepreneurship. And third one is retained earnings. Retained earnings. Retained earnings. Retained earnings are also known as undistributed profit. Undistributed profits. There are certain part of profits which are not distributed among the shareholder, and it is kept, and that profit is known as undistributed profit. Sometime in the examination, what happened? Operating surplus given. If operating surplus given, compensation given, mixed income is given, no problem. But Sometimes what happens, this rent and royalty given, interest given, profit. Sometimes profit is not given directly. Dividends, corporate tax, retained earnings, these items are given. So we have to identify and we have to include into the net domestic product. Next one comes the mixed income of self-employed. Mixed income of self-employed means the income consists of the income, let us see, which is not classified in terms of rent, interest and profit. It is the mixture of the property income. It is the mixture of the income of the enterprises, etc. So that income we call, let us see, mixed income. Mixed income, the example of mixed income is such as the farmer, such as the barbers, such as the shopkeeper, such as the doctors, such as, so this type of income, such accountants, then advocates. So these incomes are coming under the categories of mixed income. I think this is clear to all of you. So national income is the sum of net domestic product, factor cost, and NFIA. So we can write this formula. So domestic income, we can say this will be added. This will be added. So we can write this formula of the net domestic product. Let us see how can we write this formula. NDPFC. So NDPFC is equal to, the first one is compensation of employees. Compensation of employees. Second one is operating surplus. Operating surplus. Third one is mixed income of self-employed. This can be further written, compensation of employees can be written, wages and salaries, and then employer's contribution to social security schemes plus rent, royalty plus interest plus profit. Okay, we can write profit only. Profit plus mixed income. Mixed income of self-employed. So mixed income of self-employed, this will give us the NDPFC. So NDPFC, and then net factor income from abroad. Whereas let us see what is net factor income from abroad. Net factor income from abroad. It is net factor income from abroad. It is the difference between the factor income received from foreign countries and the factor payments which are made to the foreigners. So we can write net factor income from abroad is the factor income earned from abroad. We can write FIFA just to memorize FIFA, factor income earned from abroad, and the factor income paid abroad, factor income to abroad. So it means, let us see, the factor income received by the resident of our country from foreign countries, and let us see the factor payments which are made to the non-residents. The non-residents, they are working in our countries and they are also earning the income. So what we pay and what we receive, their differences give us net factor income from abroad. Sometimes, let us see, this net factor income from abroad, sometimes it is positive, sometimes it is negative, and rarely it is equal. So if suppose this net factor income from abroad, the factor income from abroad is less than the factor payments which are made to abroad, then we have to take the negative sign. But sometimes, let us see, the factor income received from foreign country is more than the factor payments we are making, then we can take positive. So this national income, sometimes it will be positive and sometimes it is negative. So question arises, what is the difference between this domestic income and national income? So domestic income, what is the difference between national income and the domestic income? The difference between the domestic income and national income is the of the net factor income from abroad. I think this is clear to all of you. In the examination, sometimes question asks to calculate GDP market price, to calculate GNP market price by this method, by income method. If suppose, if from this we have to arrive at GDP market price, GNP market price, GNP factor cost, you are knowing, this do not include the value of depreciation, this do not include the value of indirect taxes. So if you want to arrive at GDP market price by income method, then certainly what can you do in this, let us say, NDP factor cost, you have to add net, let us say, first you have to add the depreciation. Depreciation, you are knowing, is also known as consumption of fixed capital. And another one, another item you have to add is the, to make it market price, is the net indirect taxes. Net indirect tax. In net indirect tax, let us see, net indirect tax. This is the difference between indirect tax minus subsidies. So these items we have to remember. So GDP market price with the income method is equal to NDP factor cost plus depreciation plus net indirect taxes. And net indirect taxes is equal to indirect tax minus subsidy. If suppose if we want to arrive at GNP, suppose this is NNP factor cost is given and we have to arrive at GNP. This is given and we have to arrive at GNP market price. GNP market price. So what we have to do, just like this GNP, then what can we do? This GNP market price will be equal to GDP market price plus net factor income from abroad. And this formula will be used. So these are the different formula we have derived. And this formula will be used while do the numerical question. So let us see what we have learned in this method. We have learned how the national income is measured with the income method. We have seen the components of the national income by income method. First one is net domestic product factor cost. Another one is the net factor income from abroad. Net domestic product, domestic income. Domestic income is having three components. First one is compensation of employees. Second one is operating surplus. Third one is the mixed income. And let us see, compensation of employees further classified into the wages and salaries and employer contribution. Second one is mixed income is classified into rent, royalty, interest and profit. Profit is further classified into dividends, corporate taxes and retained earnings. And mixed income, you are knowing, the earnings of self-employed and self-owned resources. So the income received for the self-employed and self-owned resources are known as the mixed income. Mixed income do not classify the income of the property and income of the enterprises. And that is why we call it the mixed income. So I think this concept is clear to all of you. I hope this income method is clear. This formula we'll use while we do the numerical question. Okay, thank you.